subscribe, I think, and you should. My name is Yetu. I run an online fashion school. You need to measure where you can improve your fabrics and Lagos, Nigeria, also tailor to your taste. So for female and male and children, and the online classes are also ready to wait. Go to Instagram page or use the one on your screen to get more details about those tickets. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe. Tell your friends to come, drop your comments, drop your likes. If you have anything you want me to do, please drop it in the comment section. I will try, so I promise I'll try my best to make the video. So today I'm back again. I want to talk about the GRECIAN neckline. I've had people complain because I use the miniature pattern. Miniature pattern is when you try and draft like for a dog size. But so many people complain they couldn't get it, and I think maybe a lot of people want to relate to it. So what's a GRECIAN neckline? This is a GRECIAN neckline. This is my own version of GRECIAN neckline, which I made, and I just felt okay, this is a nice neckline. Let me just use it to teach people. It's a GRECIAN neckline with an handkerchief flare. If you don't know how to do an handkerchief flare, I have a video on it on the page. Go to the channel and you can know how to do the handkerchief flare. So this is two flares of handkerchief flare, but I'm particular about the GRECIAN neckline. Yes, before I go to that, I talked about a cutout on your kimono. This is a kimono dress. Like I said, the sleeve is cut with the budget. But the video I made, I taught you how you can do a hole on the kimono. But for this one, this is just your the kimono line. That's, you know, when your shoulder line that extends down, and then you do your sleeve width, and then you curve it back to a little after your armhole. So it's that shoulder line that you have. You can also just, you know, sew it from the beginning. You can sew a little forward if you don't want your bra line to be showing. You can sew like maybe an inch or 2 inches forward, then leave the sewing space and go and continue from there. So that sewing space you leave, you just hem it inside. You can also create a hole like this for you. If you want it wider than this, you can, you know, just leave it till the end of your armhole. But you know, this is starting straight from my neckline, so you can just sew your own a little for maybe 1 inch, 1.5 or 2 inches away from your neckline. So that, stop the sewing, then leave that space open, go and continue sewing. So place you leave, you'll definitely go and end it. So this is also a version of a cutout on the kimono that I treated in one of the videos. So go to the channel. Once you know how to put a hold on your kimono, you can get it from there. So back to our GRECIAN neckline. Now what I would like to talk about the GRECIAN neckline is the shoulder line is not always wide. You know, if it's already wider than this, then it's no more looking like a GRECIAN neckline. I'll see pictures of different GRECIAN necklines I'm dropping on the page, where you can have an inspiration of how a GRECIAN neckline looks like. I'll try to look at a picture of where I got this dress so that you can see how mine looks on my body. Now this is a GRECIAN neckline. It always comes with the eye neck. So that's, you should not grab the eye neck. It always comes with the eye neck. It always comes with not a wide shoulder line, something of 2 inches, nothing more than that. Then, you know, it looks like a, then you also need your upper bust region. So this is a posterior cut. So I'm not going to, the one I'm teaching is a normal body cut. So you can do it on a posterior cut, you can do it on your normal body. Now this is a two cut, and I put the GRECIAN on it. You know, this one is on its own. But I could have just cut a little and attached it on the two at this place. But this time I followed, you know, add the GRECIAN just, you know, on it. It's another fabric on the, so I cut the top as a two cut, and I cut the GRECIAN on another pattern, and I placed it on it. So if you want to do yours and on a two, you know, on a posterior cut, you can just do your posterior two, and the upper part of the GRECIAN line to wherever your tube is getting to, place it inside and top stitch the upper part, and the tube makes the GRECIAN neckline. Now about the back body of the GRECIAN neckline, obviously you know that the neckline has to relate. So however the neckline is on the front, the back should also relate with it. So that means it would also have, now like I said, I cut this at the two cut, I just put the straps in. If you are cutting with the bodies, then the arm will have to come in to meet that neckline. So there will be like a lot of space. It will look like a C back. So at the back, if you are cutting the back, but you know that your neckline has to meet. So this is the two and just a strap. If it's a full back form, you know, from just from here, you draft it and panel out to your armor. A GRECIAN neckline is always a sleeveless armor. Yeah, so you have to. Neckline, because first thing you have to first draft your eye neck. So for my eye my neck, I use 3.5. I used to use 3, but since I gave birth, I now use 3.5 because I'm now fatter, you know. So your neckline too, you can just make it your basic. Now normally my basic neckline is a 2.5, depending, that's my pattern drafting. If I use a free hand, is a 3.75. So I'm just going to be leaving it at that, at 3.5. So GRECIAN neckline should be close to your neck for starters. It should be. Now for my pattern drafting, like I said, my neck is actually 2.75. For my free hand, if I do my back into 4, my back is 15 into 4 is a 3.75. But I'm going to just leave it at 3.5 because it's a native. If it's a material, I can leave it at the 2.5, which is my basic round neck. You know, if you want to do anything like bishop color, any close color. So that's that. I draw my neckline. I neck 3.5. So this is a native. I don't like it too close to my neck, especially if it's lace, so that it will not be scratching me. So whatever you do, nothing white. That's the first thing. The next thing for you to do is to get your you know, upper bust. Upper bust is yoke above the bust. My upper bust, depending on occasion, I use 6, sometimes 6.5, sometimes 7. But for this class, I'm just going to do a 6. So my 6, I will just you know, first draw a straight line. Now just on this measure. Once I get the straight line here, I get the straight line in the middle. Okay, I draw my straight line. That's my, you know, upper bust. So for that upper bound now, we have to, you know, get the center bodies. How wide do you want it to be on the center bodies? So I put center bodies. I'm just going to do a 2.5 inch. If it's too much by 2.5, we're going to increase it. Now this this 2.5 now, then on the neckline, I told you the shoulder line should just be like a 2 inch. So I'm doing 2 inches for myself. You can do, let's say, maximum of a 2.5. if it's wider than that, it doesn't look like a GRECIAN line anymore. So for this, I did a 2 inch. If you want higher, you can do 2.5, but by wider bodies, maybe a size 14 or 14, can be 2.5. this place I did a 2.5. if you have wider bodies, you can do a 3 or a 3.5. so that being said, we're just going to draw this to the middle. I'm just going to draw this to the middle in a curve, you know, looking for the curve that will suit it. But now this 2.5, we will need to make it deeper. So we're going to do like maybe 1 inch below this point. So 1 inch below the 2.5, go like that. So again, so 1 inch below, link it to your 2 inches. So my 2 inches. Now this 1 inch below your upper bust line is not necessary. It's up to 1 inch. You can make it a little higher. But I'm doing that so that we can get our sweetheart's neck. So don't forget that GRECIAN length is a sleeveless body. So I've drafted my armor to be a sleeveless. But if you're drafting, if it's a normal body, please make sure you make it a sleeveless body. This is my own sleeveless body. It has to be a sleeveless because it doesn't use to have armor. Well, if you leave it like this and you have armor, it doesn't still mean it's not a GRECIAN neckline. So if you want it to have ammo, let me see how you can do it. So from that one, you just draw it up to meet your upper bust line. So if you want it to have sleeve, you can have it like this. Let me just cut out. So you see, this is a 2 inch. For my upper bust line, I did a 2.5. I came down by 1 inch. Now you can go deeper than this 1 inch, but I'm just going to stay safe. So I'm just going to cut out like that into the 1 inch, and I cut my cuff. So see the way I use the cuff. If you're trying to use your cuff like that, if you don't have a French cuff, I think you should get that. And I cut my basic neckline too. Okay, so this is for people, especially precious, and those that came to say they are beginners and they cannot relate. Well, most times when I make videos maybe for intermediate or advanced level students, but I will henceforth be considering beginners in most of my videos. So this is this. If let's say you want to put a sleeve. You can now join the sleeve to the GRECIAN NECKLINE. If you put a sleeve, I think it should still serve as a GRECIAN NECKLINE. But let's do it as it should be without the sleeve. So this is your armless ammo. You just take your top and plait it back. So I'm just going to blend, you know, from my upper bust to my arm. I'm just going to blend it in and trim out. So this is what I did. I blended up and I blended in so that you can have. Okay, so this is the full body. So like I said, this can actually be a bustier cut. So you know this one, you know you're going to be having your that normally what that you come up. If you want it to be a bustier cut, all you can do is just to you can cut this all the way down. You can cut this all the way down. So you can just take it down. Let me try and use a ruler. So I can just cut this all the way down. Just like my own dress. Like this, and then just lay it and then top stitch on it to you.